the end of your rotten life, you dope pusher.
Are you sure you're not just a little black?
And let me see you crawl over here, you black trash.
You want me to crawl?
What are you doing? Put that down.
You want to spit on me and make me crawl?
Did this man send you to kill me?
No. He didn't know nothing.
Take her out and kill her.
I think of all the fun I could have had with a good-looking stud like you.
You really mean that?
All your friends are dead. Well, I killed them all.
This week in Hollywood history. 1922, after two hung juries, actor director Fatty Arbuckle is acquitted of the manslaughter death of actress Virginia Rappe. Arbuckle's career never recovered from the scandal. He died in 1933. 1936, actress Olivia de Havilland is signed to a 7-year contract with Warner Brothers, following her successful screen debut in the 1935 film version of A Midsummer Night's Dream. She remained under contract to the studio until 1946. 1942, Humphrey Bogart is cast as the star of the new Warner Brothers romance, Casablanca. It remains one of Bogie's best-loved performances. And so it was, this week in Hollywood history.
Robert Osborne. Tonight we're showing some true rarities, movies thought to be lost, but recently rediscovered and purchased by TCM, so we can now show you these movies along with all the other classics in our library. Now, originally these films were made by the RKO Studios, but ownership was later transferred to former RKO production chief Merian C. Cooper. He was given the copyrights to these films as a settlement in a legal dispute he had with RKO. Well, in the late 50s, Cooper then transferred those copyrights to a business associate for tax reasons, a decision that Cooper later regretted and which resulted in the films kind of being caught up in a legal limbo that kept them from being seen for nearly 50 years. But the good news, we can now bring you these films, some of which haven't been seen since they were first released. The next one we have for you is a romantic comedy about a single guy and a single girl who share an apartment, but in the most platonic way possible. They never even see each other. One uses the apartment in the daytime, the other stays there at night. Perfect setup, until, of course, things happen. If you were with us last week to see the first three films in our Festival of Lost and Found RKO Movies, this plot is going to seem very familiar, understandably, because our film, which is called Living on Love, is a remake of one of the RKO films we showed last week, Rafter Romance, which was made in 1933 with Ginger Rogers. Our version, done a few years later, was also done on a much smaller scale than the original, but it's still a delight to see. The cast this time includes James Dunn, the leading man, J. Jimmy Dunn being the fellow who played Shirley Temple's dad in her first movie success, Stand Up and Cheer. Then a decade later, he won the Academy Award for his supporting performance in 1945's A Tree Grows in Brooklyn. Here is James Dunn with Whitney Bourne in a film lovingly taken care of for many years while it was stored at the Brigham Young University Motion Picture Archives. From 1937, Living on Love.